it back to you. Good round action. first day I taped it, Monday, October 11th, Thomas Hitman Hearn. Main Street's in downtown Houston, Texas. Buffalo knocked him down.
Not too down.
You.
Oh.
Thank you.
Frank Pitt, Thomas Hitman Hearns, new former world champion.
Right. Treadmill walking up the Empire State Building. Nuts and guts on that machine. Thank you. run at you. I'm good. Where'd you have to watch us?
There's a lot.
Light rain today.
want it wet?
Huh?
The towel, you want it wet?
No, I'll get, I'm going to the bathroom.
Oh, they see the cycle is finished.
Huh?
I didn't see the cycle has finished and now it's closed.
Yeah, it has finished. You gotta put them in the dry sheet.
Thank you. Your name, please?
Kim Jorgensen.
Question for Ward, please.
I was wondering, if the Oilers abandon the run-and-shoot offense, what offense do you think would best utilize your talents as a quarterback?
You're not playing so long, I've played so many offenses that I know a little bit about every type of offense. I really like the Memphis Football 49ers offense because it reminds me a lot of what we do, but it's more of a running game involved too. So if we didn't run the running shoot, I think more of what the 49ers do is the offense gets the ball out of your hands.
And your name?
Moon Sultan.
And you have a question for Ward?
Mr. Moon, is this other team ready to turn things around?
I think so. After last week's game, I think the schedule is favorable for us. I think it's time to kind of stick around. We just have to go out and get the job done and play up to our capabilities. But there's no question we're ready to just turn around. It's been a tough 5-6 weeks.
We're coming back with Bum Phillips after this.
Week goes to victory.
Oh, yeah, so you liked what he did, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Well, all right, we appreciate you being on the show. Oh, yeah. What is the way back? Wrap your feet around.
Thank you.
now this afternoon. Green Bay has won four of the last five games between these teams. Their only time to pick our running back for Green Bay. The Packers are now training their leading offensive line state. For Eric Pittman's city, not all along. Green Bay will try to get to it early from the Steelers. One down to the federal line with Chief Hoffman. Ricky White had three big sacks. Neil Broncos comeback to the Packers last game. I'll look at today's topic today. It's Brad.
Yeah. Yeah, I think things are going to settle down and everybody will be in their position then. We'll get things back on track.
Penny, seeing how Joe Montana has performed this season for the Chiefs when he's been healthy, if you had it to do over again, would you trade Joe?
It's not would we trade Joe. Joe wanted to be traded. Because of the situation out here, because of his intense competitiveness and his desire to play, he really wanted to be traded. He wanted to be traded to Kansas City, and that's where we traded him. I don't think Joe right now, if Joe was playing for the 49ers, he would really have a tough time because Steve Young's taken quite a beating so far this year.
But next, we'll jump from Sunday afternoon straight into prime time with the Hearns Center when we continue live from New York on the NFL. The NFL today is sponsored by Lincoln Mercury and the complete line of Lincoln Luxury Automobiles. Lincoln, what a luxury car should be. And by American Airlines, something special in the air.
Hey, Bill.
Me and I need him to spot me. doesn't count.
Keep stats.
Both of us can count.
Hey, Sarah!
How many touchdown receptions, Steve?
Hey, Sarah!
He has more opportunities to count than I do.
Is called an umpire.
Oh, shit, man.
line consists of the referee, head linesman, line judge, back judge, side judge, field judge, and umpire.
See that U on his back? That, my friend, means you are the umpire. Now look at these handsome fellows. Only one member of this rogue's gallery of coaches has played in the NFL. Guess who?
I bet when you're against the 1962-1963 season, it's fun. I'm a little heavier now. Maybe you recognize me without my hat and my gray hair. It was still fun.
Hey, wait. I also know about losing hair. And so does this guy. True or false, in Tom DeLandry's first season as head coach, his Cowboys did not win a game. True or false?
I won 270 games during my NFL career. But the first season, we didn't win one. We had a 0-11-1 record. Hey, Terry, thanks for asking.
Ah, you're welcome, Coach. Now for my next question. Whoa, wait a second. Hey, no, not you. You over there. Quit cheating. Stop the cheating right now. Yeah, you. I'm looking at you. I'm going to hit you.
Sorry, folks, but I had to do that. That's better.
Now, what does the term two types mean? The guys stuffed into small outfits? Tight ends in the offensive formation. The way players under their breath describe their coaches in a really big game. Or none of the above. The answer comes from a man who could never be called too tight.
They may have some other meanings. Okay. Limited to my narrow mind scope. It means two tight ends in the game at one time.
You see that guy down there holding the down marker? What is his official NFL title? And don't say the owner's son.
The originally known as the box man is a box pound with this contraption, a wooden box and a rod, which gives a spin to indicate the area of town.
Now this is the famous alley-oop pass.
To be the alley-oop third. No time for any help.
Make the catch on the alley-oop play.
RC Hearns. That was a guess. That was a blind guess. I knew it wasn't playing for a blank one. I caught the famous alley-oop pass. My name is RC Owens. Yes.
A fellow professor suggested the next essay question. Describe the NFL's version of the nickel pack. A guide package would be 10 defensive backs. Hear that? If a nickel package is 5 defensive backs, true or false, a dime package is 10 defensive backs.
I got every bit of that
dime package. It'd be 6 or more.
Next question. Which of these is the correct signal for loss of down?
Oh, yeah, the signal for loss of down. We had that last week.
Hey, that better not be a crib sheet. I see old Tom at his arm. Next question. When Hank Graham called out,
come on, Lenny. Lump it in there, baby. Just keep matriculating the ball down the field, boy.
Was he yelling to Lenny Moore, Lenny Dawson, Lenny Wilkins, or Lenny Bernstein?
Oh, come on, Jerry. Everybody knows, come on, Lenny, referred to Lenny Dawson.
Oh, you're on your plate, Lenny.
No, I haven't, Hank. And that's why it's time for the lightning round. In this American field goal kicker, which field goal kicker was known as the Toad? A. Jan the Toad Stinneroo. B. Pete the Toad Gogolak. C. Lou the Toad Groza. Or D. All of the Toads above.
My name is Lou Groza, former place kicker of the Cleveland Browns. My nickname is the Toad. And to show you that I still have one, I'll put it up here. It's tough to get it up now, but they still keep it.
Great to see Lou still alive and kicking. Now the next question is a musical one. Name this famous NFL tune. One, two, and a three. Okay, Maestro, hit it.
I'm so fast, I know you're good. I know you're good. I know you're good.
here's a tie-breaking question. How many game balls was the home team supply for a home game for the National Football League? A, 24, B, 34, C, 44, or D, the visiting team brings its own football.
Darius, I've told you once, I've told you at least 14 times, the correct answer is 24. Pins down, everyone. Quiz is over. Time to total up your score. If you got them all right, then you're the next NFL. Probably an owner. And if things look glum, cheer up. You can still be an NFL studio host or his sidekick.